Afgelopen weekend wist Ajax met 3-0 van RKC te winnen. Dat het een stroeve wedstrijd was, maakt voor Lassina Traoré niets uit.
The win was the most important, was the positive thing. Sometimes we have to do like that because we saw some games we play good and we didn't win. So it's better to win and then to play shit than to play good and lose.
You scored a goal as well. How happy are you with your goal?
Really happy because I was looking for that. It is a goal for striker. If you watch the highlight from some games in England or in Spain, you're gonna see that kind of goal.
De pas 19-jarige aanvaller uit Burkina Faso werd in de tweede helft vervangen door Klaas-Jan Huntelaar. De jonge spits leert veel van de routinier.
It's something unbelievable. Yeah, you see, play for Milan, for Madrid. We have good connection, really good connection. I call him always trainer because I always look at how he's doing, what he's doing. Yeah, so we have a really good connection. Yeah.
What does he say to you?
Always give me advice. And yesterday after the game, he say, I play 60 minutes and I score one, and he played only 30 and he scored one, so I had to score two or three. He always pushed me. Yeah.
Het gaat goed met de jonge spits. Hij voelt zich thuis in Amsterdam en is hier gelukkig.
Really happy. The country, the city, I really like it. And then I'm getting used to the weather. That's the most difficult one. And then that's it. I'm really happy. Yeah.
Yeah, is it difficult to get used to the weather?
Yeah, very difficult if you're from country with 45 degrees, 40 degrees. To hear is something different, big difference.
Traoré spreekt zijn ouders nog dagelijks. Ze kijken iedere wedstrijd en laten hem na afloop weten wat ze van de wedstrijd vonden.
They are really proud to see me playing on TV. It's something big in Africa, it's something big in Burkina. To sit and see your son play on TV, everybody is looking him playing, so it's something big, yeah.
You're a big example in Burkina, I think.
Yeah, me and my cousin and some few players. Yeah.
De spits maakt steeds meer minuten in het eerste en dat blijft bijzonder.
Yeah, it's something amazing. Yeah, still realizing and then, yeah, just it's like a dream. It's like a dream for me, so I'm really happy.
Could you imagine this as a kid when you were young in Burkina?
It's difficult. I always see the people playing the TV and I always look at myself and I say one day I will play on TV like that. I will play big games like that, yeah.
Traoré maakte veel minuten bij Jong Ajax en laat het nu ook zien op het allerhoogste niveau.
I'm growing, I'm still growing and I have a lot to learn. So I hope I will continue in this way and then always try to learn from someone from the experience that I had from the last games, yeah.
And can you describe to me or also to the fans, how did you become so strong?
behind is a lot of work, a lot of hard work, a lot of sacrifice, yeah. I train like normal with the squad, and then when I have some extra to do, like header, shooting, left foot, yeah, that kind of thing I do and then that's it.
Donderdag staat Getafe op het programma. Traoré kijkt er nu al naar uit.
It's a big game. Europa League is another level. So we have to step up. We have to do everything right. So I'm still confident. I'm still doing what I have to do. So I'm confident for that game.
Do you look forward to the game?
Yeah. Because it's gonna be my first European game, so I'm really excited.
How do you think that will be, your first European game? Can you describe that?
It will be amazing. The first 5 minutes will be great. And then after I will realize that I'm playing a big game, so I have to be on top. When you arrive on the field, yeah, the adrenaline will come, so you will be focused, yeah.
What do you think your mom or dad will say to you?
They will wish me good luck, and then after they will, if there is something to correct, yeah, they will do also.